AIDS Eradication by 2030, a review of key criteria. In 2015, the United Nations set an ambitious target to end the AIDS epidemic by 2030. As we move closer to this deadline, it's crucial to assess our progress and determine whether we're on the right path. Several key criteria serve as vital indicators of our progress towards AIDS eradication by 2030. Can we say that the number of people living with HIV is reducing? Does the percentage of people accessing antiretroviral therapy increase? Does the rate of new HIV infections show that we are winning the race? And is there a reduction in the number of AIDS-related deaths? Let's examine these metrics from the years 2020 to 2023 to gauge our trajectory. You are watching Zoom Hospital Channel, and I am Dr. Kayode. According to the Joint United Nations Program on HIV and AIDS, approximately 38 million people were living with HIV worldwide in 2020. Notably, 27.4 million people were accessing antiretroviral therapy, marking a significant increase from previous years. However, an estimated 1.7 million people became newly infected with HIV, indicating a concerning trend. Moreover, 690,000 people died from AIDS-related illnesses, highlighting the continued urgency of the AIDS response. By the year 2021, the global community intensified efforts to address the HIV epidemic amidst the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. The number of people living with HIV remained relatively stable at around 38 million. Encouragingly, the number of people accessing antiretroviral therapy continued to rise, reaching 28.2 million. However, there were approximately 1.5 million new HIV infections, signaling a slight decrease compared to the previous year. Similarly, AIDS-related deaths declined to 680,000, reflecting incremental progress in reducing mortality rates. The year 2022 witnessed continued efforts to accelerate progress towards ending AIDS by 2030. As of year 2023, the global response to HIV continued to gain momentum, with concerted efforts to achieve the 2030 target. The number of people living with HIV remained unchanged at 38 million, highlighting the need for enhanced prevention strategies. I think it's time to start asking a more specific question since we are talking about eradication. First, is there a reduction in the number of people living with HIV? Advancements in treatment have improved the life expectancy of those living with HIV, contributing to an overall increase in the number of people living with HIV globally. While this may seem counterintuitive to the goal of eradication, it signifies progress in identifying and providing care for those affected by the virus. Another important question that must be answered is, can we say there is an increase in the number of people that have access to antiretroviral therapy? From 2020 to 2023, efforts to expand access to treatment have shown promising results. Global initiatives, such as the Joint United Nations Program on HIV and AIDS, 90-90-90 targets, aim to ensure that 90% of people living with HIV know their status, 90% of those diagnosed receive antiretroviral therapy, and 90% of those on treatment have suppressed viral loads by 2020. Progress towards these targets has been significant, with many countries making substantial strides in improving antiretroviral therapy coverage. Moving forward, we need to see a downward trend in the number of people who became newly infected with HIV. From 2020 to 2023, there have been both successes and challenges in this regard. Efforts to promote comprehensive prevention strategies, including condom distribution, pre-exposure prophylaxis, and harm reduction programs, have contributed to a decline in new HIV infections in many settings. However, certain populations, such as men who have sex with men, people who inject drugs, and young women in sub-Saharan Africa, continue to experience disproportionately high rates of new infections. Furthermore, preventing AIDS-related deaths remains a primary goal of HIV interventions. The expansion of antiretroviral therapy coverage has played a significant role in reducing mortality rates among people living with HIV. However, disparities in access to treatment and healthcare infrastructure persist, leading to higher mortality rates in certain populations and regions. The facts and figures shared in this video do not show that the world is on the path to eradicating HIV by 2030, but with improved efforts we can be on the right path. There are a lot of efforts made on providing cure for HIV, and this has given a lot of hope. We have a lot of videos on HIV cure research, and we will add a link to it in the description below. Kindly subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell so that you can be notified anytime we release a new video with a life-saving medical innovation. You can